forza che aiuto.
Inavyo vizuri kiwa live, so like let's say nikitigani unaona naweza weka hapa kuzi najaribu kutafuta kiti yenye naweza kele hapa ikae hivi kuzi na maybe iko clear.
Atangaliwa
lifted up. Yeah. Wow, yeah, that's nice. For you, that's why we need you here.
Thank you.
kila mtu. Chakula zenye meza nyuma na chini kwa adjusted good trying. Okay, try it. If we turn it around, yeah, because we want to see where it works better.
Spirit to minister with us, oh God, this program. Father, let your angels, oh God, feed this house. Okay. We are not alone. We are a backup. We are a backup. We are a backup. Run. This is the name of the Lord. Thank you. hiyo neema na katusha aya katusha chochote lift up our hands to the Holy Ghost. Lift up your hands to the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost is here. Thank you, Holy Spirit. As my sister was praying, the Holy Spirit dropped a word in my spirit. I want us to pray for that before we worship. It's so strong in my spirit. Zechariah chapter 1, verses 18. From 18, I think from 18 to 21. It says about, let me just read it. Can I have your Bible, please? If you have word.
Every day in Hayakutu Tepida,
behold the King, and we want to behold you, Jesus. In the beauty of your holiness, we want to behold you. In the beauty of your holiness. Ah, Jesus. Yes, you are. You ought to carry light. You ought to carry power. I am in the Jesus. A King of Zion, we exalt you. Ah, Jesus.
What is the intention of your heart? What is the motive of your heart?
Are you just singing that song or you're really adoring him? Jesus, in the beauty of your holiness, we exalt you. We exalt you, Jesus. I stand in awe of your presence. Your presence is heaven to me. Your presence is heaven to me. Who is like you, Lord? Thank you, Jesus. We give you glory.
Stuff. And women, if you know some men, tell those men did in life, because God called me to live holy and righteous, and all we see is mighty women of God living holy and righteous because the men have taken a back seat. But it's time for us to lift up our voice, whoever you are and wherever you are, however you got there, and confess and proclaim the Lord Jesus Christ so that souls can be saved. We're starting to fail, but I recognize in this season, I recognize in this time, there's a shift in the spirit. There is a shift in the spirit realm. See, when that COVID came into the world, it reminded me of the book of Isaiah, where the Bible says, go in your house and rest a little while until the death angel pass by you. But I'm telling you right now, we have the spirit of God. We have the blood of Jesus that stole the sting of death and overcame the grave. It's time for us to have some walking on water experience. It's time for us to have some dead raising experience. It's time for us to walk in the anointing that rose Jesus from the dead. He went down into the grave, not to just be dead. He went down according to the scripture. He preached the gospel in the grave. He took the keys of the death, and he took the power of death. It's time for you to walk like it. It's over with how we've been conducting ourselves. The world don't care nothing about you, and the world doesn't love nothing about you, and the world is bold about who they are. They're commanding you to do what they say. But where are the children of God? Where the Bible says the creation of God is looking for the manifestation of the Son of God. It's time for you to lift up the voice of the name of the Lord. It's time for you to show forth the praise and glory of God. If you are not going to do it, the Bible says the rocks will cry out in your place. You don't want no rock crying out. The only rock we need is the solid rock of salvation, the Lord Jesus Christ. The Bible says the builders rejected him, but he has become the chief cornerstone. It's time for us to transform our thinking. It's time for us to transform our mindset. If you won't serve the Lord, you might as well serve him with everything you got. If you won't praise God, you might as well praise him like you lost your mind, because the world don't care about you. And then the Bible says, in the blink of an eye, suddenly Jesus shall appear. And it doesn't matter who you are now, you shall be transformed and made like him. But the Bible says his reward is in his hand. He will give you what you worked for. If you play on time, you will get eternal damnation. If you play with your soul, you ain't going to heaven. But he's going to be listening for those that are praising him. The Bible says, blessed are they who are found laboring when he returns. We can't sit around no more. Are we not the children of God? Are we not the royal priesthood? Are we not the sole heir to the throne of grace? Are we not citizens of heaven? We need to walk like that. You need to walk in that anointing that breaks down all those chains. When you feel the spirit of the enemy trying to come against you, you need to say, I bind you by the name and the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ, who delivers our soul, because we have power once we receive the Holy Ghost. And that power transforms the atmosphere. It's time for us to have an atmosphere change. It's time for us to have an anointing change. It's time for us to have a heart change. And it's time for us to have action change. We need to change our actions. We need to change the way we conduct ourselves. We need to change the way we function. We need to overcome whatever distraction has kept us back this long. See, God is looking for somebody that's going to lift up their voice. God is looking for somebody that's going to shut down the lies of the devil. One thing I talked about at church Sunday, and I talk about now, the Bible says the enemy will bruise your heel, but you shall crush his head. Where are the head crushing saints at? Where are the head crushing saints at that will crush the head of the devil every time he brings something against you, every time he brings an accusation, every time he lies to you? You get to walk in on him. You gotta crush the head of the lying devil and stop his plan, because right now, saints need to be snatching people out of the hands of the enemy. You need to be saying, listen, come with me. I found the way out. I found the deliverance. I found the salvation. I found eternal life. His name is Jesus. If you walk with me just a little while,